Hi, I'm Caroline, and I am an accessibility tester here with NNELS. And today I am about to show you how books that are properly formatted with semantic elements appear and are used by people with screen readers. And I'll also show you some books that are not formatted properly and what happens with those. So I will start with a book that has little to no semantic structure and then continue on with a book that does have the things that we would be looking for, like image descriptions, tables of content, headings, and in some cases, pages if they're available. And I will do the same thing with an iOS device. The devices that I'm using are an Android tablet, A8, and an iPhone 11. So here we are. I am going to show you the first demonstration on my Samsung tablet. It's an A8. And I will be using the application Easy Reader. So here we are at my app screen, and we are going to go to my app, which is Easy Reader. Just going to get it to read.
Ipsum, author. Lorem Ipsum, the novel. One. PNG. Library and Archives Canada cataloging in publication. L. Ipsum, author.
So what you just heard was basically what I think is the cover page. And it gave the name of the author, but there was some kind of image that it didn't tell me what it was. So I don't know if it's a picture of the author or the title of the book done in image. This is not helpful to a reader, but here's what we have. So we'll just keep on going. The next thing that I'm going to be looking for is the table of contents. And to do this, I would go to Book Navigation. So in this whole book, I only see, I think it said two items. So one is the novel and then something that says 0%. So I'm going to click on the first one to see what that is.
One.
Just move it forward a bit.
One. PNG. Library and Archives Canada cataloging in publication. L. Ipsum, author. Lorem Ipsum, the novel. L. Lorem Ipsum, the novel. L. Lorem Ipsum, the novel. L. Ipsum. Ipsum. I.
So, as you can see, my hitting next to go to a supposed next section did nothing, just continued to reread the same section over and over again. And that would not be helpful if you're trying to read a textbook or if you're in a book club and you don't just want to read something straight through in one sitting. So I have changed the navigation settings so that I am going to try and navigate by headings in a book. And let's see what this does, because headings are a great semantic tool for us to be able to jump from section to section and read as much of the book in the most efficient way possible. So let's see. It says no next heading.
No next headings. So apparently there are no headings in this book, which is another big problem for the book. I also can say that there are no page numbering in this book, but let's go find out. I'm going to go into book navigation. That's where it would normally be. It says page unknown. There is no page information that's in here. So if you're part of a book club, there is no way for you to follow along where everyone is. If they say, oh, this great quote is on page 50, you're not going to page 50. Okay, we are at my app screen again, and this time we're going to go hunting for a book that works, that has the elements we want. Use the app. And I'll just get it to start reading.
Cover for famous modern ghost stories by various authors. A woodcut type of drawing of a man on a choppy sea, in a rowboat, at night. He peers through the fog but doesn't see the ghost who hovers nearby, looking down at him. In the distance, the moon is partially obscured by a rocky cliff. Famous modern ghost stories.
So that was an excellent book structure, because I can tell right now exactly what the book is about, and I even had the pleasure of listening to a description of the cover, which is a rare treat. So now we're into the book, and we are going to go looking for a table of contents to find out just what's in this book. We're going to go into book navigation here, and there are apparently 7 items. So let's go see what they are. Okay, we're just going to select one to explore.
The Bowman. Audio not available on this device. The audio clip here is a spooky soundscape with ghostly moaning, cruel laughter, rattling, a shrill scream, and deep drums. A drawing of a bow and a quiver of arrows, surrounded by a bouquet of roses and foliage. By Arthur Machen. The Bowman. By Arthur Machen.
So, this was actually an interesting situation that comes up often with books that have different types of media in them. And sometimes one kind of media will not work. But the authors here and the publisher were kind enough to give us an actual vivid description of what's going on with this chapter. So I kind of like it. So now let's go look for headings in the book, which is something that all of us use who are using screen readers to navigate to the different sections of the book. And sometimes subsections within a book. So we are at headings here. So we'll go back into the text. So I went and looked at the headings just a second ago, and it turns out in this book that the headings and the chapter titles are one and the same, which is actually quite nice. And if there were subsections, they would probably be heading levels 2. And if there are even smaller sections in that, they might be 3. That was helpful. And I think that's it.
Okay. And here we have my iPhone 11, and I'll be using VoiceOver. And I will using the application VoiceDream Reader.
VoiceDream Reader.
Here we are on my homepage for my iPhone, and we are going to go into VoiceDream Reader to
take a look at a book that doesn't have any semantic markup.
Voice Dream Reader. Double tap. Voice Dream Reader. Library. Button. Library. Button. Science in the Kitchen / A Scientific. Now reading. Lorem Ipsum. The novel.
His
and
book.
Add. Button. Library. Button. Position. 0%. Button. Adjustable.
We're at the top of this.
Double tap to enter a percent value. Swipe up or down with one finger to adjust the value.
Let's go see what it tells us.
Vertical scroll bar. Free. Select text. Headings. Vertical scroll. All images. Vertical headings. Select play. Button.
ISBN 978-1-23456-789-0.
Night sky.
1. Nonsense. 2. Not much of anything juvenile literature. 3. Nonsense.
Now let's go see if there are sections or a table of contents or any navigation tools that we could use in this book.
Vertical scroll bar. Free. Select text. Headings. Vertical scroll bar. Headings. Bookmarks and highlights. Locations. Heading.
And let's see.
Close. Selected. Headings. Bookmark. Highlights. Selected. LITN underscore. Selected. LITN underscore ebook. 0%.
As you can see, we only see one item, and that's not particularly helpful if you're using this book for an academic purpose or for a library.
Nonsense - juvenile literature.
Pause. Button. Adjustable. Pause. Button. Dismiss pop-up. Double tap to dismiss pop-up window. Locations. Heading. Close. Selected. Bookmarks. Highlights. But selected. LITN underscore ebook, 0%.
Library and Archives Canada cataloging and publication. L. Ipsum, author Lorem Ipsum, the novel / L. Ipsum. ISBN
978-1-23456-789-0,
soft cover, 1.
This book with this application seems to have page numbering built in, so you can actually find out where you are in the book, which is helpful, but unless you know to do that and to scroll, you would not be able to use this in any kind of helpful way.
Okay. Nemo anim ipsum voluptatum quia voluptas sit disperator, about 57 seconds.
You can, however, navigate this book with percentages and time, possibly, but no one in a book club would be doing that. So you would kind of be out of the loop with the discussion.
Voice Dream Reader. Double tap.
We are at Voice Dream Reader, the app that we will be using today with my iPhone to explore a book that has many of the features we want.
Voice Dream Reader. Double tap to open. Voice Dream Reader. Add button. Science in the Kitchen / Now Reading, Famous Modern Ghost Stories, Various Authors, about 54 minutes, add, button, library, button.
And here we are in the book, and let's go see what it has.
Cover for Famous Modern Ghost Stories, by Various Authors, a woodcut type drawing of a man on a choppy sea, in a rowboat, at night. He peers through the fog but doesn't see the ghost who hovers nearby, looking down at him. In the distance, the moon is partially obscured by a rocky cliff. Image.
So it described the opening, the cover page for us right at the beginning, and the image description was very well done and clear, and is obviously the first thing you come to, which is perfect. That's what we want. Now let's go see if there is a table of contents.
Cover for Famous Modern Ghost Story. Heading about. Heading. Headings, bookmarks and highlights, locations, heading.
And we are in the headings tab and locations.
At the gate, 0.2%. Lejaya, 13.6%. The Bowman, 55.7%.
Let's just click a random one.
The Haunted Orchard. Audio not available on this device. The audio clip here is a spooky soundscape with ghostly moaning, cruel laughter, rattling, a shrill scream, and deep drums. By Richard Legallian. The Haunted Orchard, by Richard Legallian.
As you can see, it actually tells us that there is an audio clip that we can't here right now, but it does give a description of it as to what you would hear and see, which is very helpful. And with this book and this application, you will also notice that you can get page numbers.
Play, night sky. Spring was once more in the world, page 41 of 69. Page 42 of 69. Page 43 of 69.
So if you're using this book for a book club, you would be able to participate because you would know that they're talking about something on page 42. You can scroll to page 42 and find it. Not the most ideal way. I would prefer to see a page tab on the bottom that I could search by page or go directly to the page. But this is helpful nonetheless.
I hope this presentation has been helpful. I was able to show you how a book that has proper structure works and how useful it can be versus a book that doesn't have that.